Jersey 101.5.
And New Jersey chime time is 9:09, and that could only mean one thing.
From the man who brought you bread and milk, it's Vic Dibitetto.
How you doing, baby?
Talking Jersey with Steve Trevelise, tonight at 9.
It's over, Steve. Hug your family, kiss your parents, and pray for the best and hope for the worst. We're done.
Other than that,
Steve, I can't complain.
Steve Trevelise, Monday through Thursday, 7 to 11 p.m. on New Jersey 101.5 and NJ1015.com.
And here he is, Vic Dibitetto. What's happening, my friend?
Good evening, Mr. Trevelise. I have a wonderful little snippet to share with you.
Do please.
I just came from the Freehold Movie Theater, the Dumb and Dumber, which I was happy with the first one. But the reason why I really went was to see my Mall Cop trailer.
Ah!
And I did see it, and only in New Jersey. You know, I'm so excited. When my face came on, my wife said, "Don't do it, don't do it." I stood up and said, "That's me!" Only New Jersey, some guy in the back yells out, "Yeah, I'm Robert De Niro." There you go. Jersey humbles you.
I am so proud of you, man. I sent that all over the place. We got it on NJ1015.com. I mean, you are prominently throughout that trailer. It's not just like you got to blink your eyes or you miss you. You're really through it.
It's just amazing. It's surreal. I don't know. You should have seen my nose hairs. I was ready to press. Wow.
IMAX. Hey, you know what? Maybe get your own sitcom, right? They're canceling Hot in Cleveland. It'll be the Vic in Jersey show.
I don't watch sitcoms, Steve, because it's all garbage on TV. I have two broke girls. I'd rather watch two flies hump than that stupid show. These 20-something-year-old granola heads in L.A., these TV executives, haven't a clue. Sit down and watch The Honeymooners. That is the blueprint for comedy. All your great comedies come from Jersey, New York, Cramden,
Ralph.
They see this working-class, blue-collar place in one room in a kitchen with his wife. Timeless. You can watch The Honeymooners over and over. You think my grandkids are gonna watch the Big Bang Theory? Are you kidding me? You need to come about me, my family, about living with my son. He's 27 years old. He's an artist. He graduated FIT. Yeah, artist. That big snowstorm we had after Hurricane Sandy, instead of helping me shovel the snow, he painted a picture. Comedy. None of that Jersey Shore or Mob Wives or Real Housewives. That's not reality. Come to my house on Christmas Eve. That's reality. My grandmother, 4 feet tall, still wear, got a picture of Jesus Christ shaking hands with Frank Sinatra. Other than that, Steve, I can't complain.
Other than that, Vic, where you going to be, man? You're everywhere.
This Friday, Reva Blue in Lyndhurst, New Jersey, but the big show, Catch a Rising Star with you, November 28th. And folks, if we don't sell it out, guess what? I don't come back. It's that easy. You're bitching, you're moaning, you're whining. Get the frickin' ticket. I'm waiting for you to get the ticket.
We're lighting candles over here, Vic. That's doing very well.
St. Anthony upside down, too.
I got the quarter underneath. Hey, Vic. You know, Mike Trout from Millville, right? He got the MVP. How about that for the American
Great
League?
Player, and he's from Jersey. And as a matter of fact, my landscaper's son-in-law is Todd Frazier.
What? Reds. Are you serious?
Yeah.
Oh,
landscaper Kevin, if he's out there. Kevin! Anyway, Todd Frazier's brother is a son-in-law.
How about, did you meet him?
Nah, but I heard he's a sweetheart. I'm dying to meet the next time I come to a Pity Field, he's going to get me tickets.
Yeah, I know. You're a diehard Yankee fan. You know, Derek Jeter's from Pequannock.
We're entering the dark ages. Another 10 years before we win a World Series. I mean, they should dig up for Billy Martin, for Christ's sakes. This Girardi, he gives me agita. He's always looking at the books and says, "Go with your gut feeling, you moron." Like the executives in L.A., go with your gut. Somebody have the balls to get a good freaking reality show. Look at Honey Blue Bowl. Look at that
I want to know what athlete did you ever grow up with or know? Like, I know you know, like, you know, baseball players and stuff. Any Jersey athletes you know besides Todd Frazier that you like hung with or anything?
I can't answer that because I grew up in Brooklyn, and they were either dead or in jail.
Hey, you're going to know everybody. You're going to be like a magnet now. Once this movie hits, it's already happening for you.
Well, you know what, Steve? I'm humble. I got people telling me, oh, you're a superstar. What superstar? I take it a day at a time. You're only as good as your last good deed. This movie could flop, and this Hulu thing I'm going to flop. All the phone calls will stop. And I'm tired of hearing, don't forget where you came. I remember my mother. And I call her every day. That's where I came from.
Hey,
don't forget the little people. I thought, what are you doing? A midget tells you that.
Hey, when the phone calls, there'll always be one phone call that'll keep ringing. It'll be from me. You got it, my friend.
Steve. Most of my fans are loyal, and I love you guys.
You got it, buddy. We love you, too. We'll talk next week.
You got it, Steve. Take care, guys.
That's Vic Bibitetto. 1-800-283-101.5. He's the best. He just hurts you. He's so funny, he hurts you.
Did anybody get the St. Anthony upside-down statue?
I did.
It's St. Joseph, by the way.
Oh, it is? St. Anthony. Joseph. My mother, every time we lost something in my house, we got to say prayer to St. Anthony.
Yeah, no, I know that.
But now, what did you grow up on? What baseball? Like, what athletes from Jersey did you ever grow up with, play against,
Jersey?
Whatever? Well, I'm going to go Jersey because he's from Jersey.
Because he said
Todd Frazier.
He said
Tom's
Todd
River.
Frazier. Who do I know? David De Jesus went to school with my daughter.
Oh yeah,
yeah.
Oh okay.
I don't know what he's doing now. I don't know. He was playing center field for the Cubs, wasn't he?
I don't know.
I think he was playing center field for the Cubs, and I think he's going backwards. I have no.
No, he's, you know, like, because I know, like, when Mike Trout, he's from Millville.
Yeah, right.
He's a diehard Phillies fan.
Oh, okay.
And he'll call, he's playing for the Angels, and he'll call his father, how'd the Phillies do, Dad? And, you know, because, old habits never die.
No, the Angels.
Of course, when it came time to sign a contract, he went right back to the Angels.
Oh, are you kidding me? No, follow the money. Are you kidding me?
Philly.
Yeah, really.
But that's going to be.